should I just tell you the answer?
Well, you need to give me both. You give me the answer, give me the way you found it, you give it to me in the order you want.
Okay, so the way I found the first question
was
subtracted 7 by 5.
Okay, so you did 7 minus 5.
And then I got 2.
Okay, so that's 2 seconds, right?
Yep, and then I subtracted 16 minus 12.
Okay.
And then I subtracted 2 by 4, or 4.
So you got 4. So you got 4 centimeters.
And then I divided 2 by 4, and I got 2. And then...
Wait a minute.
You do this a lot. You say it backwards. If I do divide 2 by 4, will I get 2?
4 divided by 2.
Right. Okay, so you divide 4 by 2. So you got 4 centimeters.
And then...
Divided by 2 seconds.
Yeah.
And you got 2 what?
2 centimeters equals 1 second.
You got 2 centimeters equals 1 second?
2 centimeters... Every 2 centimeters, every 1 second, 2 centimeters fills up.
Okay, can we say that a little more succinctly, a little more briefly? You're right. I mean, what you're saying is true. Jackson?
2 centimeters per second.
2 centimeters per second. 2 centimeters per second. All right? You didn't do that. You definitely should be writing it down. Why not? It's for free. You didn't have to do anything. At least write it down. Start improving today. 2 centimeters per second. Is that pretty green? Does that make sense?
Yeah.
2 centimeters per second.
Trucking right along. I watch it for 1 second. It fills up 2 centimeters. I watch it for another second, another 2 centimeters, another second. And what happens?
Another 2 centimeters. Very good. So we've got a very key piece of information here. 2 centimeters per second is how fast this water is moving. We can use that information and this information to figure out how high the water was at 0 seconds. Remember, we talked about that last time. You remember how that went about. Everybody knew it besides Jackson, besides Kate and Tiana.
With the finding how high it was,
yep.
I did, so because it fills by 2 centimeters every second, divided 12 by, I did 5 times 2.
Why 5?
Because 5 is the second number.
It's the what?
It's the lowest of the numbers so far.
The lowest of the number of seconds,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, of seconds.
So it's like the most... time, it's the earliest
time. Yeah,
earliest time, yeah, the earliest time,
yeah.
Smallest time.
Yeah, and so I did 5 by 2, which is 10. And
what, did you divide by 2?
No, I multiplied.
Multiply by 2. So 5 seconds, right, times 2 centimeters per second, right, and seconds cancel, 5 times 2, 10 centimeters. Right? What did you do with that?
And then I subtracted it from 12.
Subtracted it from 12. So you went back in time, back to 0 seconds. Right? Makes sense. You take 12 centimeters, you go back 10 centimeters, because that's how many centimeters it would have moved in those 5 seconds, those first 5 seconds. So let's go back from 5 seconds to 0 seconds, right? We went back 1 second, 2 seconds, 3 seconds, 4 seconds, 5 seconds, right? And we found out that it was how high. How high was the water?
It was 2 centimeters.
Right? Back it up. Okay, so here's the thing that we're going to extend from this. We're going to take it beyond this review and ask, can we write an equation that will tell me the height at any time? So if we said that the time was represented by x, and y represented the height at that time, can we write an equation that would tell me the height at any time x?
Yeah.
Let's give that a try. Let's each of us try and, with this information, right, it's going 2 centimeters a second. At 0 seconds, it's at 2 centimeters. So I guess I'll squeeze that in right here. 2 centimeters. So you've got kind of a base point, starting point. You know how fast it's filling up.
If I told you with that information, can you tell me how high it is at, you know, 23 seconds? I bet you could. Can you write it as an equation with a y and an x? Like, well, x represents seconds and y represents height. Let's start with 0 seconds. How high is it?
2 centimeters.
After 1 second, how high will it be?
4.
It'll go up 2 more, so it'll be at 4. How about at 2? Go up another 2, and it'll be at 6. Let's say we jump all the way up to 10 centimeters. Or sorry, 10 seconds. 10 seconds. How many centimeters will it be at 10? 22.
At
22?
It'll be at 22.
Tiana convinced everybody that it's 22.
It will be at 22 because with that, because we started at 2 seconds, then we go 10.
Sorry, 2 centimeters.
We started at 2 centimeters.
Right.
And so we go 10.
Listen to Tiana, please.
And we go up 2 centimeters every you know, 1 second.
Uh-huh.
So we're going up that many. We go 2 times 10 plus 2.
No, look at the board.
2 by 10 plus 2.
2 times 10, that's how high it's going to, that's the amount
it's going to go
in 10 seconds, plus the 2 that it started at.
And so it'll be at 22.
22. Okay? 22. Aha. Now how about after 30 seconds?
When do we get out of this class?
Just keep participating and don't worry about it. Guys and girls, act like you care.
I care.
She's getting tired of feeling like I'm one of the few. Stop worrying about what time you get out. Stop worrying about anything else other than what I'm asking you to do. Unless you have some kind of emergency, which none of you do, concentrate on what I'm asking you to concentrate on. Okay? In 30 seconds, how high will the water be? Someone other than Tiana. Jackson?
62.
And how did you come by that?
I did 30 times 2 and then I added 2.
30 times 2, and you always got to add that 2 that we started with, right? So 2, what's that? Oh, what's that? 2 times 30 is 60 plus 2, 62. Now, here's a big question. What I'm asking for is after x seconds. So, after x seconds, how high will it be?
X.
Y.
Y.
Well, it certainly will be y, but how will we calculate the y?
R. No.
You have at least two very nice examples.
X times 2 plus 2.
X times 2, I'll write it as 2x plus 2. Obviously, Sarah. Y equals 2 times any amount of time plus the 2 centimeters we started with. Right? Sense. Got a starting point. You add on 2 centimeters every second, so 2 times the number of seconds. There we go. Okay. Now, this was what I said was your homework. I hope you did it just so that you're prepared for this conversation. And then you stop talking to each other across the room. So if at 2 seconds it's at 31 centimeters and at 5 seconds it's at 22 centimeters, then how quickly is the glass filling with water? This might actually be kind of a weird word to use. Why would that be a weird word to use?
Because it's not filling.
It's filling, but it's like decreasing seconds.
It's negative filling.
It's negative filling, yeah.
We're going back in time.
or we're going back in time. Because I heard rewinding the video. But if time is moving forward, let's assume that it is, then it must be empty, right?
When it started.
Reverse filling.
When it started 2 seconds and then go down to.
Right. 2 seconds is first, 5 seconds is next. We know that about seconds, right? That's just how it is. Right.
Take off the thing from your head. So I want you all to figure out how fast it's really reverse filling or negative filling or really emptying of water. The answer to my question is?
Filling 3/1.
3/1. Do we agree with 3/1?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Wait.
Well, okay. Well, Sarah, it sounds like you got some people who agree, some people who disagree. So how'd you go with 3/1?
I did 31 minus 22, and that equals 9.
Yeah, I guess it's right.
Yeah.
And then I did 5 minus 2, and that equals 3, and it was 9/3, and then I just divided it by 3.
Okay. And you know what? Now that I think about it, the way I asked this question the second time, I'd agree with you. Because how fast is it emptying? 3 what?
3 centimeters over 1 second.
It's emptying that fast. Now, what if we looked at it as filling? How fast is it filling? Is it filling 3 centimeters a second?
Mm-hmm. No.
No. How fast is it filling then?
3 seconds over 1.
So would this be negative?
It would just be negative, right? It would just be going down. That's how fast
negative
it would be.
Negative 9.
Filling.
So it would be
negative
9
every 3 seconds, right?
Yeah.
So, same as negative 3 centimeters every 1 second.
Yeah.
And they're the same thing. Negative 9 centimeters
what?
Per 3 seconds.
What?
Negative 3 centimeters every 1 second.
Yeah, I got both.
Negative 6 centimeters every 2 seconds. No, that's not going to work at all.
Nope.
So negative 9 centimeters over 3 seconds, negative 3 centimeters over 1 second. I guess we can go the other way. Negative 6 every 2. Negative 6 centimeters every 2 seconds. Negative 18 centimeters every 6 seconds. They're all the same thing. They're all the same ratio of centimeters to seconds. Okay, so that's our rate. That is the rate at which it is, if it's negative, it's the rate at which it's doing what?
It's decreasing.
But what word am I looking
going
for?
Going down.
Emptying.
If you think that it's emptying, then it's emptying. It would be emptying in a positive way.
Unfilling.
You're
drinking
filling.
It's negative.
It's filling.
Negative filling.
It's filling. Yeah, negative filling. It's filling in a negative way. It's emptying in a positive way. It's filling in a negative way.
Unfilling.
Okay. How high was it when it started? What how high was it at 0 seconds? Can we figure that out?
It was seven, six?
Yes.
0 seconds, it was
5 plus 2 is 7.
Yeah, because if it started
at 2, that's the seconds. This doesn't tell me how high it is. This is how high it is.
Oh, so then
two,
it's.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it's
sure.
31 centimeters. No,
that's 30 seconds. What about at 0 seconds?
0 seconds is at 1.
I got it. You got it, Avery?
It was at 37 centimeters at 0 seconds.
Who agrees with 37? 37?
Dang it.
Wait.
37,
that's higher than?
Yeah,
37.
Definitely
37. Well, it is going down, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's going down, so wouldn't it be higher when it started at 0 seconds?
Yes.
If we go back 1 second, how many centimeters would we actually go up?
Maybe 38.
We would go up 3, which would bring
3 more. And up another second, we go up 3
every
more.
Second.
It's 3 every second. We're going to go back how many seconds, Avery?
6.
Wait a minute.
Or no, 2.
We're going to go back 2 seconds.
2 seconds, but 6.
Which would mean it was 6 centimeters higher.
Which
right?
would make it 37.
Wow.
Which would make it 37.
I'm getting good at this.
You are getting good at this thing. So
I'm getting all right.
If we start with 31, right, then we want to add on the centimeters that we would have lost in those 2 seconds, right? We're going to put them back on. So we go 3. Times 2 seconds, right? So 31 plus 6, 37. Now, same question again. We know that it starts, right, at x is 0 seconds. It starts at 31 centimeters. Okay. We know that it's going down, right? It's going negative. It's filling up at negative 3 centimeters per second. So can we write an equation that for any number of seconds, any number of x seconds, it'll tell us how high the water is at x seconds, okay? Look at your notes from the previous problem we just did. Remember that we wound up figuring out that there was a starting point, which you always have to like add on, and you have to figure out how much it moved because of how much time went by. Okay? So you can write an equation that tells you that x seconds, what would you do with x to calculate how high it was at that time? So work on approach this little bit by little bit. At 0 seconds, we start at 37 centimeters. So after 1 second, how high will it be?
16?
Oh,
no, no, I got,
34. How you get 34?
37 minus
3. It's
going to
go down 3, right? 34. How about after 2 seconds?
31.
We even know that already, right? How about after 12 seconds? Either tell me or just walk me through figuring it out.
Negative 5.
Yeah. Why -5?
12 times 3 is 26.
Okay. So?
And so 36 is larger than 31.
Why are you talking about 31?
Because that's.
Is 31 where we started?
No.
Where did we start?
We
started at 2?
We started at 37.
We started at 37 centimeters, so
37 minus 36.
Why 36?
Because
12
times 3 is
36. Because 12 times 3 equals 1. So at 12 seconds, it'll be at 1 centimeter. How about at x seconds? Give you the pieces of information that we've been working with, how much water there is to start with, how fast it's filling. You write the equation.
Okay. Not our homework.
It's what you're doing right now. All right, who's got an equation for us? Dalton.
3x plus 5
makes a lot of sense, right? Audrey, why does y equals 3x plus 5 make a lot of sense? Maybe stop talking to people.
Okay.
Why does it make sense?
Because it goes 3 centimeters every second,
uh-huh.
And you go plus 5 because that's how many centimeters it started out at 0 centimeters.
Start at 0 seconds with 5 centimeters. You get 5 centimeters like free. It just starts out that many. And then we add on 3 times however many seconds. 3 times 1, that'd be after 1 second. 3 times 2, that'd be after 2 seconds. 3 times 5, that'd be after 5 seconds. Just any number x you want to plug in for the number of seconds, this equation will take it and tell you how high the water should be at that time. Let's do it again. But now, it's 5 centimeters every 2 seconds. Okay, give that a, we had a scratch over that. Last one, y equals, how much did we start with?
14.
14, right? So we're going to add on stuff from there.
Yes, I did it right.
5 plus 2. Well, we can't do 5 plus 2. These aren't the same thing.
Oh, yeah.
5 divided by 2.
X. Times x.
Let's think about it for just a second. Let's test it at 2 centimeters. Or 2 seconds, excuse me. So it's at 14 centimeters in 2 more seconds. In 2 more seconds. 1 second, 2 seconds. How high will it be?
19 centimeters.
19?
Yeah.
2 seconds?
Oh, 10.
Close to 14.
Oh, 29.
14. How many centimeters will it rise in 2? Oh, sorry, 2 seconds. Right?
Yeah, I told you.
Yes, it will be at 19 centimeters because it will have raised how many centimeters?
5
in 2 seconds. 5 for 2 seconds. So, yeah, if we plug it, if we multiply by 2, we get 2 times 5 amps is 5. 5 plus 14 is 19. Have a good day. Goodbye.